In this video, we're continuing on with the Systems of Equations by Elimination worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section, picking up where we left off with number 9. Now, numbers 1 through 8 was very easy to either add or subtract our equations because by adding or subtracting, we were able to cancel out a variable right at the start. However, in number 9, that is not possible. We're going to need to manipulate one of the equations in order for a variable to cancel out. Now, if we look at our x values, we have 5x and 10x, and in order to get them the same, we would need to multiply the first equation by 2, and then we could subtract. If we were to look at our y values, we would need to multiply the first equation by 7, and then we would be able to add to cancel out the y. Multiplying by 2 is easier than multiplying by 7, so let's go ahead and multiply that first equation all by 2. So that's multiplying 5x by 2, y by 2, and the 9 by 2. So 5x times 2 is 10x, y times 2 is 2y, and 9 times 2 will be 18. And then we'll rewrite our other equation. 10x minus 7y equals negative 18. Now, in order to cancel out that 10x, I'm going to subtract the equations. 10x minus 10x is 0x, which we know is 0. 2y minus a negative 7y is 2y plus a positive 7y, so that would be 9y, and that's equal to 18 minus negative 18 or plus a positive 18, which is 36. So because 0 times x is 0, we were able to eliminate that x variable. So now we'll just divide by 9 in order to solve for y. Y is going to be equal to 4, since 36 divided by 9 is equal to 4. Now we'll take that y value and plug it back in to either the first equation, the second equation, or the new equation we created. Let's go ahead and plug it back into this original equation. So we'll have 5x plus y, which is 4, that's going to be equal to 9. So I'll subtract 4 from both sides to get that 5x is equal to 9 minus 4, which is 5. And when I divide by 5, I'll get that x is equal to 1. So in number 9, x is 1 and y is positive 4 as our solution. 1, 4. And number 10, let's manipulate our y variable in this second equation. In order to do that, I'll multiply this entire equation by 3. So rewriting my top equation, I'll have negative 4x plus 9y equals 9. Multiplying my bottom equation by 3, I'll have positive 3x minus 9y equals negative 18. So you can see that when I multiplied by 3, I was able to get 9y. And in this case, that 9y was subtracted. So now I'll just add these equations together. Negative 4x plus 3x is negative 1x. 9y plus a negative 9y, or 9y minus 9y is 0y, which we know is 0. And 9 plus negative 18 is a negative 9. 0y is 0. So I'll have negative 1x equal to negative 9, and when I divide by negative 1, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 9. Now I'll take that value of x and plug it in to any of my equations, either the top equation, the bottom equation, or my new equation. Let's go ahead and plug it into my second equation. So I'll have 9 minus 3 times y equal to negative 6. I'll subtract 9 from both sides to get that negative 3y is equal to negative 15, since negative 6 plus negative 9, or negative 6 minus 9, is negative 15. And when I divide by negative 3, I'll get that y is equal to a positive 5. For number 10, x is 9, and y is 5. That's my solution. And number 11, I'll be able to cancel out my x's if I multiply the top equation by 3. So negative 3x times 3 is negative 9x, plus 7y times 3 is 21y, and that's equal to negative 16 times 3, which is negative 48. And rewriting my bottom equation, I'll have negative 9x plus 5y equal to positive 16. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to subtract because that will allow my equations to cancel out. So negative 9x minus a negative 9x is going to be 0x. 21y minus 5y is 16y. And negative 48 minus 16 is negative 64. So all I have to do is divide by 16 in order to solve for y. So I'll get that y is equal to negative 4. And then I'll take that value of negative 4 and plug it back into any of my three equations. So let's plug it into this bottom equation. So I'll have negative 9x, since x is my unknown, plus 5 times negative 4 equal to 16. That's negative 9x plus negative 20 equals a positive 16. So I'll add 20 to both sides to get that negative 9x equals a positive 36. And when I divide by negative 9, I'll get that x is equal to 36 divided by negative 9, which is a negative 4. So for number 11, both x and y are negative 4. In number 12, it will be easiest to multiply by 3. So I'll multiply that top equation by 3, and then I'll be able to cancel out my y variables. Negative 7x times 3 is negative 21x, plus y times 3, 3y, and that's equal to negative 19 times 3, which is negative 57. So then, rewriting my second equation, I'll have negative 2x plus 3y equals negative 19. Now, in order to cancel these 3y's out, I'll need to subtract the bottom equation. So negative 21x minus a negative 2x will be a negative 19x. 3y minus 3y is 0y, and 57 plus 19 is negative 38. 0 times y is 0, so I'll just need to divide by negative 19 in order to solve for x. So x is going to be equal to a positive 2, since negative 38 divided by negative 19 is positive 2. Now I'm going to take that value of 2 and plug it in to any of my equations. Let's plug it into this bottom equation. So I have negative 2 times a positive 2 plus 3 times y. Y is what we're solving for, and that's equal to negative 19. Negative 2 times positive 2 is negative 4 plus 3y equals negative 19. I'll add 4 to both sides to get that 3y is equal to negative 15. Negative 19 plus 4 is negative 15. So when I divide by 3, I'll get that y is equal to negative 5, since negative 15 divided by positive 3 is negative 5. So if x is 2, y is negative 5, my solution is 2 and negative 5. Now continuing on to the second page, we'll go over number 13. However, before I go over numbers 13 through 16, go ahead, click that like button, and while you're at it, subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. For number 13, we're going to be able to multiply this bottom equation by 2. So we'll have 16x minus 10y equal to 10, and when we multiply the bottom equation by 2, 2 times negative 8x is negative 16x minus 2 times 6y, which is minus 12y, and that's equal to 2 times 6, which is 12. So adding these two equations, I'll cancel out my 16x, since 16x plus negative 16x is 0x. Negative 10 plus negative 12 will be negative 22y, and that's equal to 10 plus 12, which is a positive 22. 0 times x is 0, so dividing by negative 22 will give me that y is equal to a negative 1. Now that I know that y is negative 1, I'll plug negative 1 in for y and solve for x. So plugging it back into this original equation at the top, I'll have 16 times x minus 10 times negative 1 equal to positive 10. 16x plus a positive 10 equals 10. Subtracting 10 from both sides, I'll get that 16x equals 0. And dividing by 16, I'll get that x is 0. So 0, negative 1 is my solution and number 13. And number 14 by 2, multiplying out my bottom equation in order to have a 14y. So rewriting my top equation and then multiplying out my bottom equation, 2 times negative 6 is negative 12x minus 2 times 7, which is 14, and that's multiplied by y, and that's equal to 2 times negative 10, which is negative 20. Now I'll add these two together. 8x plus negative 12x is negative 4x plus 14y plus a negative 14y is 0y, and 4 plus negative 20 is negative 16. 0 times y is 0, so when I divide both sides by negative 4, I'll isolate my x variable and get that x is equal to a positive 4, since negative 16 divided by negative 4 is positive 4. Now that I know x, I'll plug that in to solve for y. Using this first equation, 8 times 4 plus 14 times y equals 4. 8 times 4 is 32 plus 14y equals 4. If I subtract 32 from both sides, I'll get that 14y is equal to negative 28. And finally, dividing both sides by 14, I'll isolate my y to get that y is equal to negative 28 divided by 14, which is negative 2. So my solution in number 14 is 4 for x and negative 2 for y. For 15, I can either multiply the bottom equation by 4, or I can multiply the bottom equation by 3. Let's multiply by 3. I'll have negative 4x minus 15y equals negative 17. And then I'll have negative 3x plus 15y equals negative 39. And I'll simply add these two equations. Negative 4x plus negative 3x is negative 7x. Negative 15y plus a positive 15y is 0y. And negative 17 plus a negative 39 is negative 56. Dividing by negative 7, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 8. Knowing that x is 8, I'll plug it into this original second equation. So I'll have negative 8 plus 5y equals negative 13. Add 8 to both sides to get that 5y is equal to negative 5. Dividing by 5 will give me that y is equal to negative 1. So 8, negative 1 is my solution in number 15. And lastly in this video, I'll be going over number 16. For number 16, I'll multiply that top equation by 2 in order to get 14y. So I'll have negative 2x minus 14y equals 14 times 2, which is 28. Negative 4x minus 14y equals a positive 28. So if I subtract this bottom equation, negative 2x minus a negative 4x is a positive 2x. Negative 14y minus a negative 14y is plus a 0y. And 28 minus 28 is 0. So I'll get that 2x, or if I divide by 2, I'll get that x is equal to 0. So knowing x is 0, I'll plug that in to that original first equation. So 0 minus 7y equals 14. So dividing by negative 7, I'll get that y is equal to negative 2. 0 for x and negative 2 for y is my final solution in this video. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 17 through 24. And if you didn't do so before number 13, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. And if you found it really helpful, share this with your peers.